We're gonna take a trip back in time. Let the music soothe your mind. Behind our little white house and our brand new barn, and keeping it country farm.
Hi, this is Richard Lynch here to Keeping It Country Farm. The boys and I will be playing some great country music here shortly. Stick around.
I have to ask you, how many veterans do we have in the house? Anybody, any veterans? Can we get a round of applause for these wonderful men and women that served our great country? God bless you all. Here's a little song that me and a couple friends in Nashville wrote this little tune right here. And the song is entitled Love Tattoo. And I know what you're thinking, for the folks that haven't heard this song, what is a love tattoo? Well, it has nothing to do with ink. The love tattoo is something that our men and women came back and gave something they sacrificed, whether it was a psychological sacrifice or if they came back kind of shot up. So their love tattoo is something that they gave to all of us in the form of service to our country. Here's a song called Love Tattoo.
Loves his God, his kids, his wife. For them, he gladly gave his life. He served his country as many do.
For them,
gladly give his life. He served his country like heroes do, and he came home with a love tattoo. Yes, he came home with a love tattoo.
Just a few months after I got married, I was looking around what used to be my bachelor pad, this house that had been changing before my very eyes. After we'd gotten married, I mean, here she moves in and I'm looking around. I'm like, wow, where's all my stuff? And so it was in that moment of fear when I didn't see when I couldn't find. See, I had a really nice 10 horsepower Honda boat engine laying in the living room. This nice footstool, you know, and I had some cool stuff like that. It was very unique. But all these things were disappearing or being moved or rearranged. And so I wrote this song in that moment. This song is going on 8 years now. But anyway, it's about getting married. When we first started dating, Lordy, I could not believe how much she loved football and didn't care if the house wasn't clean. She thought I was cute when I proudly hung that deer head up on the wall. It seemed like every little thing I do always turned her on. But then we got married, and that's when she started changing. The first thing she did was take that deer head down. She rearranged the whole kitchen. She ain't really into fishing like she was back when I thought I had her figured out. Lord, won't you have mercy? My pretty woman's gone crazy ever since we got married. We used to eat cheeseburgers and go out on the town. And she never seemed to care if all my buddies just hung around right there at the house. We all thought that she was just one of us boys, but with a better anatomy. She laughed at all of our stupid jokes and was impressed so easily. But then we got married, and that's when she started changing. She told all my friends you need to find a new place to go. She yells at me when I'm driving for no reason. She's crying. And me, I'm apologizing for what I don't even know. Lord, won't you have mercy? My pretty woman's gone crazy ever since we got married. Take it, Jerry. I'm eating all of my veggies, and she's talking about babies as if we could use some more responsibility. We already got two dogs. Lord, won't you have mercy? My pretty woman's gone crazy ever since we got married. It worked out all right. We got the two babies, and I got my deer head back.
But did you ever find the boat motor?
I still hadn't found the boat motor. I think she sold it.
You guys okay if I do another song off my CD? Yeah, maybe? I'm going to do a song called Quit You, and the guy that wrote this is from Nashville. He writes a lot with Chris Stapleton, so we're pretty excited to do this song. So I hope you enjoy this one.
Everybody, that was an incredible performance. Stay tuned for some more great country music here at the Keeping It Country Farm.
He served his country as many do, and he came home with a love tattoo.
And speaking of real traditional country music, Here's another new song off our current album. This album is called Mending Fences. We're awful proud of it. A little song called Country Music Isn't Country Anymore.
As a boy, I remember without fail, every Sunday afternoon, my daddy played Merle Haggard loud enough to shake the shingles on the roof. All us kids in the neighborhood knew every word that mama tried. And I've heard it on the radio not once since the day my daddy died. Hank Thompson, Johnny Paycheck, and George Jones, Patsy Cline, and Sonny James. It's so wrong, the only place I hear them say is in the Country Hall of Fame. Country radio's neglected, the legends that made Nashville what it is. Backside, I'll be gone before I hear a play. What a shame, country music isn't country anymore. How I miss Luke the Drifter when I hear that old lonesome soul blow.
One horse.
no one could tell me I had to prove them all wrong. Ain't it funny how life can teach you a lesson you should have known all along? I'm hearing daddy's word loud and clear. And if I'd have just done what he said to do, I wouldn't be standing here. Daddy's words running through my head. Take a step back, boy, figure it out. That's what he always said. Well, it didn't take long. I started thinking about all the dumb things I did, like spending my money on gold digging women and acting like a crazy kid. But as I got older, I got a little wiser and started to figure it out. So dad, if you're watching, I'm paying close attention and I'm hoping I can make you proud. I'm hearing daddy's word, ooh, loud and clear. Everybody just done what he said to do, I wouldn't be standing here. Daddy's words running through my head. Take a step back, boy, figure it out. That's what he always said. That's what he always said. Where'd you boys put my tools? Is that where you found them? Daggone boys, can't have nothing.
Hey y'all, it's been another wonderful evening here at the Keeping It Country Farm, playing along with the Ohio Hayride. We can't wait to see you next time. Until then, folks, we'll see you then. Bye-bye.